السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We're still in the month of Ramadan in 1994 in USA, touring these different cities and different states in the United States of America. And I have two pleasant experiences. One of them when I went to New York, an area called Brooklyn. Brooklyn is a very rundown area, very underdeveloped, full of immigrant, particularly Afro-American, Arabs, and Caribbean, and Latino American, and other very, very poor area, and very famous of the lack of facilities provided to this area in New York. And I went to the mosque. The mosque was small, but not the huge mosque that you can see them nowadays. Small houses connected to another. And I was talking about Umar ibn Abdulaziz and his life story. And also I was talking about heaven, because I used to read these two books, took them with me all the time. The book of the story of Umar ibn Abdulaziz, the fifth caliph, as well as Hadi al-Arwah fi Bilad al-Afrah, Ibn al-Qayyim al-Juziyya, to talk about heaven and what's in heaven and. And I mentioned the story about the different kind of transportation in heaven, and the vehicles in heaven, the animals in heaven, and also, and how Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu alayhi salam was talking about this there. And when you talk about this thing in the mosque, especially in the very holy day, holy month of Ramadan, people will be tentatively listening to you. And one of them was a new Afro-American young man who came to me after I finished my talk about Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu wa karamallahu wajhu, and told me, can I donate some money to you? I said, yes, of course. He said, I only have got this coupon, which is the food for the food of my children and my family, and it's worth about $3. Will you be able to accept it? I kissed him and I told him, of course, yes, I will accept it. Thank you very much, and God bless you. This was one of the best donations I have ever had in the whole of my life in this place. The second after that, I went to Philadelphia in Pennsylvania, and there it was another poor community in a similar mosque or a similar community center like this, but there was no food for breakfast. It was delayed, very much delay of providing us with the food. And because we had a program, an intensive program before Maghrib and after Taraweeh as well, I was getting to my angry mood because the food was not there to finish the business and prepare ourselves for the second stage of the evening. While I was a little bit agitated of the late coming of the food, I saw two young Afro-American women, bismillah, mashallah, with a very, very broad smile on the face and nur coming from the face, and they're carrying big pots of pasta. This is what they can afford to prepare for us: pasta, potato, and bread. But actually, when I looked at the smile of such women coming to me and spending all the time to prepare the food, have not had the breakfast, have troubled themselves to carry all these heavy, heavy pots of food. There was no chicken, there was no, meat, nothing. It was only pasta, potato, and bread. This cleared my mind and cleaned my heart and washed my anger, because I felt very small, like a dwarf standing next to these two young, strong Afro-American women who knocked me down with the broad and deep smile coming out of the depth of their heart, from the depth of their heart. And these two incidents happened to me in the month of Ramadan. I was very thrilled by the $3 coupon donation from the Brooklyn man, as well as from this kind of hospitality, which I have never seen it anywhere. But even this did not make me to become ahead of the fundraising campaign, ahead of Wasim, who managed to beat me at the end of the month. I think he was ahead of me with 5 or 10,000 dollars at that time. God bless him and God bless Islamic Relief. But actually, this is how we feel the value of the poor people who give you as much as they can. And the most important thing to give to you is the love and the feeling towards you and the hospitality for the Brooklyn man as well as the Afro-American ladies in Pennsylvania, in Philadelphia. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.